though I admit I'm curious who she might be. Who are you? And what are you doing on my ship?
Belltower keeps two ships in port. They're going to plant that package in Administrator Wang's office. Then you hop in a cargo pod and off you go. And where she may port, I bet you find your scientist.
You're the cruise director? Because I've got a complaint.
You think you're funny, do you? Well, let's see how funny you feel after Lieutenant Keitner gets through with you. Lieutenant?
It's useless to resist. This chair has a built-in EMP field generator. Your augs are nothing but dead metal right now.
Is that so?
No doubt they will have reset to factory zero. You need a limb clinic.
You can't have it both ways, you know. You can't play the good cop when you've been playing the bad cop.
You think you're clever, don't you? But this ship is heading to a Belltower naval base, a military facility for the confinement and interrogation of unprivileged belligerents. And when we get there, we're going to take you apart.
Unprivileged belligerents. I can't wait to see how that looks on my resume.
Keep laughing, funny man, because in my experience, comedians always break first. Still, when they found you in that cargo container, you did manage to take out a number of highly trained men. Tell me something, Hotshot. Do you enjoy taking people's lives?
Not if I'm given the choice.
Oh, but you had a choice when you decided to blow up our port.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Like hell you don't. We may not know who you are, yet. But Burke's running your profile as we speak. High-grade combat spec augmentations, built to be somewhat unnoticeable so you blend in with the civs. Someone spent an awful lot of money creating you.
Lucky me.
So I guess the real question is, are you a terrorist? Or some kind of corporate thief?
Would you be happier if I told you that I'm neither?
You have absolutely no idea of the shit you're in, do you? Rifleman Bank Station is a black site. It's off the grid. No one will come and rescue you. No one even knows where it is. You'll be dropped into a deep, dark hole and never see the light of day again. Stua Mafrua, tough guy.
Commander Burke and I are returning to the base. Keep a close eye on him. You've secured his gear?
Yes, sir. Locked in one of the rooms upstairs, sir.
Good. Then you have your orders.
Pritchard. Are you there? Pritchard? Damn it.
He'll spill his guts or they'll spill them for him.
I'm not sure about that. This one's not like
Patrol
our usual.
Patrol 2 Charlie. Anomalous reading in sector D6. Monitor.
Jesus, what is it now? We just got here. Now we gotta move?
You'd rather keep standing in an empty passageway? At least this gives us something to do. Come on.
station control confirmed. Adjusting main ballast tanks. Dropping draft 2 meters.
Pritchard, is that you?
I'm unlocking the door.
You're breaking up.
Fine, the CIC.
Rifleman bank station control confirmed. Fall back, slowing to 5 knots. Warning. Unstable load detected.
Yeah.
storm seems to be calming down. Now that the brass is flying back to the base, I guess we'll... Sounds like someone running.
Pritchard.
Francis Pritchard isn't going to be hearing you anytime soon, Bratan. Altonov is close to the base and is jamming array.
Who the hell are you?
Someone who's gone through a lot of trouble to make your escape look like accident. So far, your skill at playing the ghost is working in our favor. But it's only a matter of time before those Roddy realize you slipped their brig. Get to the aft cargo bay. Find the sally port there and enter it. You're going to encounter more resistance. But the longer you stay undetected, the better off your future will be.
Initiating docking approach.
Everything's quiet in the forward hold. Looks like we might have some storm damage.
Thrusters full back. Beginning final approach to Rifleman Bank Station.
Jesus. Jesus. Don't you ever wonder what they're doing with all these people?
These people were terrorists and war criminals, of course. What we're doing is locking them up so they don't kill innocent civilians. I don't feel sorry for any of them.
Really? So what's all this bullshit Docking about calling Bay them unlawful belligerents? What does that even mean? It sounds like a made-up term to cover our asses.
What it means is you keep your mouth shut and you do what you're ordered to do. I believe what I'm told to believe. And if you had any brains, you'd do the same unless you want to join the popsicles at Mark's detention wing.
Securing bay doors. All personnel, prepare for unloading. Activating security scan. Biometric data assembled. Subject not recognized.
You're quite the goose, Bratan. Let's see if I can keep it that way.
So, you're a hacker.
There's a maintenance tunnel in loading bay 1. Access through a floor panel. Get inside. Follow the cables. And try not to kill the person inside.
Access granted. Security personnel, please comply. within designated areas. Entering restricted areas will result in termination and prosecution.
That's far enough, Jensen.
You're behind this?
I said that's far enough. I can explain everything if you just stay where you are.
Why don't you put the gun down? Then maybe we can talk.
Not yet. You've played things smart so far, but this is an enclosed room with no witnesses holding you in check.
You don't trust me. Why'd you set me free?
It wasn't my choice. As a matter of fact, I think you're going to get us both killed before this is over. But if we'd left you in that brig, who'd be around to save your Dr. Reed?
What do you know about Megan?
I know the name set off way too many bells and whistles when I added it to Burke's profile search on you. But it helped me to figure out who you are and why you stowed away on the ship. You think Belltower kidnapped her, don't you?
You want to tell me you didn't?
I wish I could. But after what I've seen this past year, all I know for certain is she's not on the base. Not anymore.
What's that supposed to mean?
Not what you're thinking. Listen, Rifleman Bank Station supports all Belltower operations in this region, Jensen. Regular contract and special op. 6 months ago, I received orders to pull every regular grade soldier and civilian contractor away from the airstrip. 2 Black Hawk helicopters set down minutes later. I thought it had to do with Australia, especially when I saw covered stretchers coming out.
How many?
5. Guarded by a heavily augmented special ops team. Burke went out to meet the leader and the whole group disappeared inside the detention camp. There's some kind of black project going on in there, Jensen. Something involving prisoners and scientists. And I need you to find out what it is.
Why me, Keitner? That is your name, isn't it? The one Burke used back on the ship?
Natanya Keitner, yes. And it has to be you, because any movements I make are noted and logged. I can't risk blowing cover.
Cover? Who are you working for?
A few months ago, an Interpol agent approached me. They've had Belltower on their radar for some time, but they've never been able to prove anything. The things that agent pointed out about this base, it opened my eyes to a lot of things. So you see, Jensen, I really am playing the good cop and the bad cop.
Tell me more about these scientists.
Technically, I'm in charge of operations here, so I keep tabs on people coming in and out. Burke keeps meeting with doctors and researchers, telling me it's part of his interrogation technique.
You got any names?
None that I trust, unless the Doe family suddenly expanded into Australia and Asia. Thing is, I don't always see how they leave.
Yet you're sure that Megan did?
The Black Hawks did. Without the stretchers, but loaded with 5 stasis pods this time.
I'm gonna need more information than that. Tell me about this black project.
I wish I could, but it's been classified. So classified, every BT suit I've talked to refuses to even acknowledge its existence.
But you've seen something.
Only the edges. This station is part base, part military stockade, and every week a new shipment of belligerents arrives. Only, Interpol says they're not on anyone's terrorist watch list. Most are just civs, harmless civs. Burke takes them into a restricted wing of the detention camp, and they just disappear.
Fine. What do you need me to do?
Hold still for a second.
What the?
Relax. I'm just compiling your biometric signature. Retinal scan, pulmonary and vascular imaging, the works. Once I upload it to the network and give Corporal Alan Tyler a security rating, you'll be able to pass through specific checkpoints in this sector.
Only this sector? Why not others?
Because you're a fugitive, Jensen. The less room I give you to maneuver in, the more likely it is you'll stay one. I can get you into the detention camp, but the interrogation wing is going to be a problem. Only Burke can give clearances for that.
And I assume you don't want me to go ask for one.
Still the comedian. There's a security mainframe inside the detention camp's central command tower. You'll need to upload this copy of your biometrics there by hand. Contact me using your infolink once you do. Any more questions?
I'd like a little clarification here about you and Burke. I take it he outranks you.
Technically, yes. But this station is only part military stockade. And while he and his unit have 100% control over the detention camp, I have authority over the base.
So I don't need to worry that this is all just some creative attempt at mutiny.
Mutiny? You think I'd risk so much because... Listen close, Jensen. Burke is a sexist, chauvinist pig. And yes, he outranks me. He's also been in Belltower a lot longer than me, so he's got more connections, which he's used to undermine me at every turn. But that is not why you and I are standing here right now. People are getting hurt. Innocent people. And we have to find out why and expose it.
Exposure could destroy Belltower.
Belltower used to have honor. We do this right, it might again someday.
The guards in the prison complex, are they Burke's men or yours?
Definitely Burke's. Highly trained, special operatives. So if you start a firefight in there, don't expect to live long.
I'll keep that in mind. I could use some more hardware. Any chance Corporal Tyler will have access to the armory?
You're still a fugitive, Jensen. I suggest you keep a very low profile. Still, there is someone who might be able to supply you. One of the base mechanics, a civilian named Quinn. He runs a nice sideline in procurement.
I know the type. Why should I trust him?
Because I do, and because he has no love for Burke. He's in the lower level maintenance area near the elevator. He'll get you what you need.
That's all I need to know.
Good. I'll upload to the security network from here, so get going. Alan Tyler will exist by the time you reach the prison security port. Just be careful and try not to draw too much attention.
Are you Quinn?
Yeah, that's me. Jensen, is it? You weren't followed, were you?
Not that I'm aware of.
Yeah, I can believe that. They're having a hell of a time keeping up with you.
I intend on keeping it that way.
Well, you've certainly ruffled a few feathers higher up. It's not like they don't know you're here. Stowed away on the ship, I mean. It's only a matter of time before they bring the hammer down. Put a stop to your gallivanting on the base. I just hope I'm not near you when the iron's hot and you're on the anvil.
Look, Keitner said you can help me. Can you?
Yeah, she told me to be expecting you. I'm just glad you came as soon as you did instead of going off on your own. There's enough kegs of powder lying around here already without throwing another loose cannon in the mix. You know how much we're risking to keep you off the radar? We've only got so much pull around here. It's Burke's show, and he'll do as he bloody well pleases. Which means stamping out any rats the moment he gets wind of them.
I'm grateful, but can we get on with it? I understand you run a nice little sideline in procurement.
Aye. From time to time you might say being inclined to do a little, how should we call it? Bartering. On the side. Since the commander signed off on it, I suppose I could open my stock to you. For a price, that is.
You mean I have to pay?
What? Of course you have to bloody well pay. Ain't exactly a fucking armory quartermaster down here. I'm just a civvy contractor trying to make ends meet. This ain't a bleeding charity.
Considering the circumstances.
Circumstances? What, that you're a fugitive and I'm risking my neck just talking to you? What are you trying to pull here? Although, I don't suppose you had anything to do with the stasis pod that was saved back in the ship.
How do you know about that?
Ah, so it was you, eh? Well, let's just say I have me sources and your little random act of kindness didn't go unnoticed. Tell you what, I'll give you a discount on me wares. Just no freebies or handouts. But now that I think of it, if you're looking for a little something for nothing and don't mind a little legwork, I've got an errand that could use running. Consider it a special offer of sorts. Interested?
All right, tell me about this special offer.
Look, I don't know if you've noticed yet, but this base is packing some serious heat. Especially in the form of those walking brick shithouse boxcars. If you get me a few odds and ends, I might be able to whip up a little something to make getting around easier, if you catch my meaning.
What kind of something are we talking about here?
Nothing fancy. Just a 329 series MPRS.
A rocket launcher?
That's right, mate. And custom built. By yours truly, of course. You see, while I might be able to get my fingers on some low-level arms, I'm a little restricted when it comes to military-grade bells and whistles. And I'm itching to try out a new trigger propulsion mix. Maybe even recalibrate the guidance system for some extra punch.
I'm not convinced jury-rigged explosives are exactly my style.
Look, I'm not telling you how to do your job or anything, but you might want to consider carrying a little extra insurance while you're here. Look, all you gotta do is find me some components. I'll do the rest. An earlier boat had a shipment of 329s, but I wasn't able to poach any of them before they made it to the armory. Luckily, the little sparrow in my employ managed to lose one through maintenance circulation, but he got himself shit canned before I could collect. Now my little beaut's lying around the base somewhere in bloody pieces. The launcher, I mean, not the wee man. Though, I've no idea what really happened to him.
Right, so, long story short, you need me to find the parts and bring them back to you.
Yeah, that about sums it up, I'd say. Just find me the trigger module, scope assembly, and launcher barrel, and we're in business. I can scrape up the rest from leftovers here in the shop.
I'll see what I can find. Any idea where they are?
If I knew that, I would have picked them up myself. You're just gonna have to make do and keep your nose to the ground. Check the obvious places first, like the cargo and receiving areas. Worst case, someone found one of the parts and brought it to administration. I looked there last.
Got it. Tell me about the commander, Keitner.
Lieutenant Commander, officially. But the grunts don't pay no mind to that. She's the commander as far as they're concerned. It's the Reds who stick to the formalities, you see. Because they're Burke's boys. The Spooks. Special Operations. You might say there's a bit of a division of loyalty among the troops.
Between Keitner's men and Burke's?
Aye. Since time immortal, there's always been a rivalry of sorts between grunts and spooks. I always assumed it came down to ego. But it's different here. Probably because Burke's different.
What do you mean?
Well, for a start, the man might be a righteous prick, but he's got the respect of his men. And the higher-ups think he's a visionary based on some fancy tech he drummed up a few years back. In other words, the man's got a lot of influence and a lot of power, and, well, I don't think that old proverb needs repeating here.
What can you tell me about this base?
Nothing you don't know, probably. To the outside world, it's a Belltower naval logistics headquarters and supply point for their Pacific operations. Beneath the surface, though, it's much, much more.
How so?
Look, nothing personal, mate, but I prefer the commander to most of the informing. As far as I'm concerned, the less I know, and more importantly, the less I say in this matter, the better off we all are.
What exactly do you do here, Quinn?
In a more civilized world, you might say I pass for the base's lead maintenance engineer. But if you look at it from Belltower's point of view, I might as well just be a glorified janitor. Pays good, though. So, you know, not complaining.
If the pay is good, why the underground market?
Well, why not? You see, civilian contractors operate under different jurisdiction when it comes to bringing outside goods into the base. So while the rank and file grunts can only order and receive essentials, toothpaste and the like, I, being the entrepreneurial chap that I am, offer them a more robust catalogue of goods and services. You know the sort. Smokes, beverages, and gentleman's literature.
How does this involve weapons?
Now, let me finish. As an enterprising fellow, I require an exchange of valuables for these slightly less than essential supplies, and often receive some very non-civilian contractor-regulated equipment in exchange, if you catch me drift. Now, normally, I launder my stock through a contact on the mainland, but a deal in Shanghai recently fell through, so lucky for you, I've got some excess inventory to move. Consider this whole arrangement a matter of fortunate timing.
And Keitner is okay with all of this?
Not exactly. You see, some time ago, the commander got wind of my little operation down here. But before she could throw me in the brig, I offered her something I knew she couldn't refuse. Information. I ain't bragging, but I've managed to build myself quite a little network of sparrows and gophers. I'd known for a while that she'd been at odds with that prick, Burke. In the end, I reached a rather simple mutual agreement. I keep her in the loop, and she keeps my neck out of the noose, so to speak. What are you buying? No reason. refunds.
Access.
Geithner, any reason Burke's got a spare retinal prosthesis lying around his office?
He just received it this evening from the Tai Young Medical Corporation. HQ had a custom set made especially for him as a thanks for so many years of good service. Why?
He'll probably be real angry when he realizes it's missing. Jensen out.
Send the report.
Oh, I'll send him a fucking report. Whoever heard of dispersing points?
Activating security scan. Biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted.
Keitner, Jensen,
what was that noise?
I'm in your detention camp and uploading to the security mainframe now.
Copy that. Any problems?
Negative. I gotta say, though, this isn't exactly what I was picturing when you described it.
Yeah, well, we'll talk about that later. Right now, you need to get inside the interrogation wing and find out what Burke is hiding. Contact me when you know. Keitner out.
This is life. I'm not a criminal.
Activating security scan. Biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted.
I'm sorry. I'll stay quiet. I promise. Just don't hurt me anymore.
Calm down. I'm not gonna hurt you.
You're not one of them? One of the scientists? Please, you've got to get me out of here. We've got to do something before they come back. I don't want to disappear like all the others.
Hold on. You said they were coming back? Who? Burke? Is he behind this?
I'm not sure. He comes around, but not that often. I know he gives the orders around here, but he doesn't seem all that interested in us beyond some psych tests and questioning. He mostly leaves us to the doctors, or scientists, or whatever they are.
Tell me about these scientists. Is one of them a woman named Reed?
I don't know. I mean, there is a woman, but her name is Kavanaugh, not Reed. I heard the guard call her that. She seems different. Like, she doesn't like what they're doing to us. I can't help but think she's being forced to do these things. The others just treat us like animals. It's horrible. I just want to go home.
I want to help you, but you've got to stay calm. Now, what did you mean by disappear like the others? What's been going on back here?
I don't know much. I've heard rumors and seen some things, and I know what they've done to me. Biopsies, blood samples, tissue cores, like I'm some sort of lab rat.
Is that why you're back here? Separated from the others?
This is where they study and examine us to see if we're compatible or something. I don't know what they want from us. Sometimes we're sent back to the cells. Those that aren't. Some of the others think they let them go, but I think they're being sent somewhere else, another facility maybe, or somewhere else inside this one.
Why? What makes you think that?
Because of the way they talk when they're with us. It's like they're looking for some kind of perfect gene match or something. I'm not a doctor. I don't understand it. I just don't want them touching me anymore.
It's okay. What's your name?
Nina Sullivan. I don't know why they're holding me in here. They just grabbed me off the street. I heard Cape Town was dangerous, but I thought with all the security around...
Cape Town? South Africa?
Isn't that where we are? I blacked out. They drugged me, I think. I was on vacation in Cape Town at the end of the summer. I was going to be starting senior year in the fall, and I wanted to have an adventure. My parents must be so worried.
I take it you're not a terrorist, then?
No. I've never done anything wrong. Never demonstrated against anything or anything. But neither have most of the girls here. I'm not sure about the men, but please, can't you get me out of here?
I know this is gonna seem cruel, but I can't help you right now.
You're going to leave me here? You can't! You have no idea what it's like. Please.
I can't have you tagging along just yet, or walking the halls alerting the guards. Trust me, when I can get you out, I will. But your best bet is to stay put.
I'll alert them anyway. Burke and the two doctors were just here heading for the morgue. I'll tell them you're here. I will. Let me out or I'll tell them, I swear.
And then what? Do you really think they'll let you go? I'm still the best chance you've got, but you have to be patient.
Please. Don't go.
So what did these ones die of, Savage?
A complete neurological breakdown, from the looks of it. Organ collapse, nerve degradation.
Find him. There's been some trouble on the base. My man will take care of it. You were saying?
We may be looking at serious cross-systemic failure issues with the OCM.
It's those god-awful implants, Gary. The whole inhumane procedure. After a while, it just burns them out.
Has this been happening at the other sites?
We've experienced some die-off, yes. But I've been told Dr. Reed's research may offer a breakthrough. If we could bring her back here...
That's not going to happen.
Then we need to start considering other options. A nanotech-based solution performed on willing volunteers.
And are you volunteering yourself, Doctor?
Tiffany, please. I need to look at the raw data, Commander. If you would.
I turned a blind eye to your little office romance, Savage. But if she becomes a problem, she will be volunteering.
Keitner. I found out what Burke's been concealing. The interrogation wing is some kind of medical testing facility. He's using the prisoners as lab rats.
For what?
Not sure. I'll need Burke's retinal scan data to find out.
I can't download that without setting off a million alarms. However, you still have that retinal prosthesis you stole from his office?
If you're suggesting I use it to fool a retinal scanner, it won't work. The eye synthetic tissue spike needs to be connected to a real optic nerve. Otherwise, it just reads as metal.
I know. That's why you need to take it to Quinn. I'll tell him to expect you. Keitner out.
Activating security scanner. Biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted. Activating security scanner. biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted.
So, what's the story? Just got off the horn with the commander. She says you got something for me to take a look at.
Prosthetic eye, one of Burke's. We need it to get past a retinal scan, but it's useless like this.
Aye. Without an active neural connection, it might as well be an expensive paperweight. May as well put a gobstopper in front of the scanner for all the good that thing will do you.
Solutions, Quinn. Think you can handle this?
Lad, I may be just a mechanic, but I'm also the only thing keeping this whole bleeding facility from sinking into the abyss. Think I can manage a simple optic frequency bypass. Just let me get me tools. Right. So that's it now. You got the eye. Sorry it took a little longer than I expected. Nearly break the damn thing once or twice. New TYM firmware and such. Now don't go fucking around with it. It's only got a limited lifespan due to the temp power source I rigged. It's only good for one use. Got it?
Why only one use?
Without being hooked up to a proper battery, like your brain, the voltage spike from a single scan will trip the surge protectors, shutting it down to prevent further transmissions. It's a redundant safety mechanism built into the optic nerve to prevent frying your noggin in a dorsal ventral feedback loop. Short of putting the thing in your own head, which I ain't exactly equipped to do, there's no way around it. Besides, I think the commander preferred this way.
Is it supposed to be moving?
Aye. Bloody creepy that is. Try not to pay it any mind now. Thing's stuck in calibration mode. Trick is, I got it thinking it's plugged into a new host. And by rerouting the system diagnostic checks, it'll keep trying to connect without detecting anything's amiss, which in turn keeps it alive in a manner of speaking. Fucking brilliant piece of engineering work if I don't say so myself.
This is pretty impressive work for a mechanic, Quinn.
What's that supposed to mean? There's more to old Quinn than meets the eye. No pun intended. You wouldn't be the first fool to underestimate my know-how.
Well, there's more to this job than just a simple battery swap. I saw you modifying the BIOS. This is state-of-the-art hardware and software. You're not just a mechanic. You're a hacker.
What are you going on about now? Ain't nothing you couldn't pull off with a degree in computer engineering and a little elbow grease. Come off it now. We ain't got time for this.
Well, hopefully this thing works.
It'll work just dandy so long as you don't do something stupid like drop it. And it ain't a bloody webcam. So don't try using it to spy the knickers up someone's skirt.
I gotta go.
Right. Do us both a favor. Keep your head down.
Goddamn son of a bitch. Thinks he's hot shit because he's in special operations.
Activating security scan. Biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted. Activating security scan. Biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted.
Granted.
Jensen, it's Keitner. Where are you?
In a well-concealed elevator inside the prison's restricted wing. Your gun-running neural engineer deserves a raise.
I take it the eye worked then. Good. Now listen, if what you say is true, if Burke really is using the prisoners here as lab rats, I need proof. Hard evidence that I can take to Interpol.
An entire prison full of kidnapped civilians isn't enough?
You're an ex-cop, Jensen. You tell me. How many death row inmates crying on about their innocence have you seen getting out?
Point taken. I'll see what I can find. Quite the house of horrors you got here, Doc. You letting anyone in, or just women?
Who are you? How'd you get down here? This is a restricted area.
Obviously. You wouldn't want the rank and file knowing what kind of sick experimentation is going on down here.
No, you don't understand. I'm not...
Where's Burke? And your research partner, Savage?
Burke went back up to the base. And Gary left. Told me to be smart, keep my mouth shut, and do whatever Burke tells me to do. For now.
For now? I heard the three of you talking up there in the morgue. Sounded like you don't exactly fit in here, Dr.
Kavanaugh. And who the fuck are you?
The name's Jensen. I came here looking for someone. Megan Reed.
Reed? I've seen her research. Gary thinks it could be the key we're missing. If she can be convinced to come here.
Megan Reed was kidnapped, Kavanaugh. Violently. As was her entire scientific team and the dozens of women you've been torturing down here.
No! You don't understand. I'm trying to save them. Gary and I, we were sent here to put the OCM project back on track. It wasn't until we got here that we realized what that meant. And by then it was too late.
OCM. Savage used that term in the morgue. What does it mean?
Organic computational matrix. It's a means of cross-connecting living brain tissue and artificial intelligence systems to create a supercomputer of unparalleled capability. Part flesh, part silicon.
That's what you're doing down here, turning prisoners into computer parts.
Human brain activity has to be integrated with the technology, or else it won't work. Even DARPA knew that.
You seem to think Megan's research is integral to salvaging this project of yours. Why?
It's not my project. Had I known before I came here...
Right, just answer the question.
We're experiencing cross-systemic failures with the tech. Over time, subjects implanted with OCM augmentations suffer complete neurological breakdown. They pretty much burn up from the inside. Gary thinks it's a problem with the acceptance of the P-dot array.
I've heard that phrase before.
It's the building block of modern neuro-augmentations. Dr. Reed's been reshaping it, changing the way it bonds with living tissue. The mutagenic gene combination she's introduced into it, well, frankly, it's astonishing.
Enough to warrant her kidnapping? So she'd be forced to work on this project with you?
She's not on this project. I don't know what she's doing or where she is. This is the first time anyone's ever mentioned kidnapping.
Just how many prisoners are being wired into this thing?
I don't know. But a lot of them don't seem to survive for more than a year. I've told the others there's no way this project can stay viable with these kinds of numbers. But the OCM computers have to have them to work.
Computers? You mean there's more than one of them?
There's several. This is just where the process starts, the factory floor. We select the candidates here, implant them, and ship them to the other locations. It's all very efficient.
Yeah, except your candidates keep dying. What does DARPA have to do with this?
Nothing. Not directly. In 2007, they started looking for research partners to help develop an artificial cognitive science program that could increase a soldier's situational awareness in the field. A number of private sector companies submitted proposals.
Belltower being one of them.
No, Belltower was a private military corporation. DARPA wanted researchers. But one of the companies who did submit something was a biotech corporation that deals with Belltower. And they believed a successful program could be designed if it could be wired directly into the soldiers' brains. DARPA wasn't willing to go that far.
So this biotech company took the idea to Belltower.
A corporation that being privately funded, doesn't have to concern itself with political or ethical debate.
You're really going to stand there and try to justify your role in this, aren't you? People are being enslaved, Kavanaugh. Enslaved and crucified.
It wasn't like that at first. I thought we were going to make a difference, do something incredible for the world.
Right. And look how incredible it turned out to be. But you can still make a difference, Doctor. You can help me blow the lid off this place.
Are you insane? I can't. There's too much money invested in this. Burke, the people I work for, they'll kill me. They'll hunt me down and kill me.
I know people who can protect you, hide you. Interpol is just waiting for evidence to tear Belltower apart.
It's not just Belltower. Oh, God. Oh, God, am I really gonna do this? You can't get me out through the prison. Burke would stop us.
Then we'll have to do what Savage did. Take a submersible.
We can't. The hatches to all the docking hangars are locked tight. The only way to unlock them is by using the security console in the prison command tower. Burke keeps an eye on us that way.
Then I'll have to go back up there and unlock it. Well, you gather as much evidence as you can carry.
Oh my God, I'm really gonna do this.
Damn right you are. Now get moving. I'll contact you when I unlock the hatch.
All right, fine. But Mr. Jensen, please, hurry.
Keitner, contact Interpol. We need rendezvous coordinates for a deep-sea submersible.
A what? What exactly have you found, Jensen?
A research complex hidden beneath this base. One of its staff is willing to turn whistleblower if we can deliver her to Interpol using one of the lab's transport subs.
Which explains why you need the coordinates. I'll see what I can do. Keitner out.
Keitner, what the hell's going on? The elevator stopped.
Burke must have intercepted our comms. Get the hell out of there, Jensen. I'll meet you.
Assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted.
Keitner!
We really broke open a hornet's nest, didn't we, Jensen?
It's bad. You need a medic.
Yeah, I'll get right on that. Got those coordinates, Jensen. But Burke figured it out. Seized control of the station and locked down the detention camp. Bastards cleaning house.
I've got to get Kavanaugh out.
Can't. Not until you stop the gas.
What gas?
Burke's enacted a scorched earth protocol to stop the truth from getting out. Poison gas in every cell. Lab tube. Unless you stop it.
Stay with me, Keitner.
There's a circuit board underneath the prison command tower. Directs the flow. Everything's connected, but might be able to redirect. A whistleblower has to live, Jensen. Only sure way. We stop this.
Keitner. Keitner!
You killed a lot of good men. Just stay alert for this Agent Burke mentioned. The guy stationed in the restricted area should be able to handle him if he shows his face. But you never know.
Right. And if he doesn't show his face, we can help flush him out once the gas takes care of this trash.
Choice ahead of you, Bratan. The prisoners. Or whistleblower. You can't save both.
What? The hacker from the ship. You've been listening this whole time?
Like Zetka said, everything's connected. Right now, gas is set to disperse evenly between the prison and the lab. All you can do in here is redirect flow out of one area into the other. Do nothing. Everybody dies. There's something.
Somebody dies faster.
Precisely. But if you want to bring down Belltower, the choice is clear. bug yet. The toxicity level is dropping. You found a way to save everyone, Bratan. You'll still need to unlock the submersible so our whistleblower can go free. Use the touchscreen in the command tower. It'll also let you back inside the base.
And why would I want to go there?
Use your head, Chuvok. The last thing standing between you and Megan Reed is Burke.
Kavanaugh, I've unlocked the hatch and I'm transmitting the coordinates to a rendezvous site.
Oh, thank God. I thought when the code yellow started...
It's over. Just make sure Interpol gets that evidence. I'm going after Burke. Jensen out.
Activating security scanner. Biometric data assembled. Subject not
ready. Corporal Tyler? Or should I say Adam Jensen? That's right. I know who you are now. Katna wasn't quite as good at hiding her tracks as she thought she was. You're clever. I'll give you that. Most men aren't capable of seeing beyond the choice in front of them. But whatever you think you've done, it's of no consequence. Helping that fool Kavanaugh escape, saving the lives of a few worthless civilians, it won't change anything. All you've done is make yourself a target. The Reed woman, this Megan you've been searching for, she's not here. And the only thing standing between you and the ship that could take you to her is me. I underestimated you back on the ship. I won't be doing it again.
Todd, you there?
Quinn? Where are you?
Getting me ours out of Dodge. Burke's had enough, and he's gunning for you. And I don't intend on being caught in the bloody crossfire. But listen, that trick you pulled with the gas, fucking brilliant work that was. Head to me shop. I left you a thing or two so you can give him hell. I'd like to say we'd meet again over a pint sometime, but, well, Godspeed, mate.
Results. In time, the gains we've made will obscure our methods. You only need to look as far as your precious Dr. Reed to realize that.
Access granted.
Got him?
How did Kinder recruit you, Jensen? She used Reed as a carrot? If I'd have known you were going to cause me so much trouble, I would have never given in to my curiosity about you.
Better keep looking.
some ways, the two of us are probably quite similar. But I question your foresight, your courage to make difficult decisions.
Thank you.
It sounds like your struggles are almost over, Bratan. Is Burke dead?
I'm standing. He's not. Let's just leave it at that.
Ugh, you don't make things easy, do you? Still, with Burke out of the picture even briefly, there's a power vacuum I can use. Return to loading bay 2. The doors between here and the docking platform will be open for you.
Last time I passed through there, Burke's men were still waiting for me.
Not anymore. Burke has just ordered them away.
Great. Except I came here looking for Megan Reed, Bratan. I can't leave without knowing.
There is a boat heading toward the location as we speak. If you hurry, you can be on it.
Bratan.
Quinn?
I'm afraid our good friend Quinn met with an unfortunate incident during all the commotion and is no longer with us.
Your voice. It was you this whole time. Who are you?
For the moment, I'm between identities. I apologize for the duplicity, but it was a necessary precaution. You had to be kept in the dark.
And Keitner? Did she know?
Commander Keitner's perception was much like yours. Shrouded. She saw what she needed to see, and was told what she needed to hear in order for me to complete the mission.
So we were both pawns, except she's dead and I'm not. So where does that leave me in your grand design?
We are all pawns in someone else's grand design, Mr. Jensen. But that doesn't make Natanya's death any less tragic. Your actions ensured her sacrifice was not made in vain, however. Dr. Kavanaugh made it out safely, and is on her way to the rendezvous site. She will expose the truth in due time.
And the prisoners?
Ah, yes. The prisoners. With Kavanaugh out, it's only a matter of time before this base makes international headlines. Until that time, however, I cannot say what Belltower will do next. I only know that a cornered and desperate bull is a very dangerous beast. We mustn't stay here much longer, Mr. Jensen, if we hope to get you away from this base.
I still have questions, Quinn, and I want answers. Real answers, no more bullshit.
You really want to waste time chatting, Bratan? Fine. I will answer what I can, but keep in mind you have a boat to catch.
Belltower probably has a battalion on its way to clean up this mess. How do you plan on keeping what we did here a secret?
I'm delighted to say that Burke did most of the damage control for us. After requesting the profile search on you, he never explained why he needed it. I believe he wanted to keep control of you to himself. Since that time, we've been monitoring all incoming and outgoing communications, and the lockdown allowed me to discreetly install a tunneler, rerouting the base's network traffic. By the time Belltower realizes something is wrong, it'll already be too late.
What about the rest of the base personnel?
Most of them think Burke is still in command. Technically, orders continue to be issued in his name, but I'm the one making the calls. I've also taken the liberty of cordoning off this sector of the base. For the moment, at least, we're safe.
Burke isn't exactly dead. And once he wakes up, it's gonna get ugly.
Like I said before, you haven't made things easier for us. But they haven't forgotten that small detail. For now, Burke remains contained. Once you're off the base, I'll find a more permanent solution.
Keitner said she had been approached by an agent from Interpol. It was you, wasn't it?
Very astute. When I learned of Commander Keitner's suspicions and insubordinate behavior towards Burke, I saw an opportunity. Pretending to be an agent of Interpol seemed the best way to gain her trust.
You mean you lied? So who do you work for?
A loose network of independent operatives, agents of conversion and equilibrium, who seek to expose corruption and assure humanity's natural progress. In truth, we are not affiliated with any global organization. But then, neither is our enemy, officially.
Your enemy? You're not just talking about Belltower anymore, are you? You're talking about...
The men and women who pull Belltower strings. The same men and women who ordered them to kidnap Megan Reed. Mr. Jensen, allow me to stop you there before you say anything that might embarrass us both.
What?
Please, I detected your CASI augmentation the moment you started to analyze my facial movement for pattern sequencing. Now, pretending you managed to convince me to be more forthcoming with my words, what is it you hope to learn?
Something more tangible than a flowery speech about idealism.
Because I admire your tenacity, I will attempt to satisfy your curiosity. But only if you'll humor me for a moment and answer a question of my own.
Sounds fair.
In Roman mythology, Janus was a god depicted as having two heads, each gazing in the opposite direction, one looking eastward, the other west. Symbolically, this meant many things to the Romans, but I'm more curious as to what it might mean to you.
Seeing into the past and the present, the beginning and the end. Alpha and Omega.
I believe you and I have more in common than you would like to admit. Technically, I suppose there is no incorrect answer. Theologians and philosophers have debated the origin and meaning of Janus for millennia. But in time, that name may take on new meaning for you.
Why? What are you getting at?
Well, the term invisible war has lost much of its significance due to misappropriation. I assure you, there has never been a better way to describe what is happening in the world. The lives of millions are being decided without a drop of blood ever spilt, but the casualties remain the same. Myself and others are fighting a never-ending battle against forces that seek absolute dominion over our fates.
You're telling me the people running Belltower want to rule the world?
Belltower Associates is no more than a proxy. Puppets on a global stage. The true enemy hides in shadows, the disembodied hands that pull the strings of Belltower and others. This is neither the time nor the place to go into detail, but everything you've witnessed here today is in direct correlation with Illuminati interests.
Roman gods and Illuminati. Wonderful.
You asked for clarity, and I'm being as honest as I can. Whether you choose to acknowledge them or not, lines are being drawn. Most will never be lucky enough to pick a side. But a time will come when you will have to. I have chosen mine.
All right. Where's Megan?
I don't know for certain. But what I do know is that earlier today, Burke issued orders to have a large group of detainees transferred off this base. Supposedly, they will be assisting at another Black Site facility.
Kavanaugh said this was just the factory floor. You're sure Megan is at this other facility?
Nothing is ever certain in life, Mr. Jensen. But it is the best chance you have. Unfortunately, the cargo ship carrying the prisoners has already set sail. But I took the liberty to send out an urgent dispatch in Burke's name, ordering the ship's captain to hold position until one more detainee could be flown on board. In stasis. A helicopter is en route to pick you up.
Wait a second. You want me to get inside another stasis pod? Last time I got in one of those things, it didn't go so well.
I know it's far from ideal, but frankly, your options are quite limited. Although, I suppose you could try swimming there.
Better be the right fucking boat this time. Because I don't feel like coming back here anytime soon.
Don't worry, Matt. It'll be grand. Besides, I thought you Americans liked riding off into the sunset.
It's done. Exactly as you instructed.
And yet you sound disappointed. You think we should have handled this differently?
I think we had a valuable asset in our hands. We're letting him slip away. He could have been very useful in the coming storm.
A hand does not need to be clenched tightly to maintain its hold on someone. Jensen carries too much baggage right now. His obsession with Reed only serves
to distract him. We could have told him the truth.
He must discover it by himself. And when he does, if you have followed my instructions precisely, we will know how to find him.
Assuming he lives that long.